Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install Kali Linux in VirtualBox. So let's get started. So first let us begin with downloading Kali Linux. So just Google Kali Linux download, you'll be getting the official Kali Linux site, which is kali.org. Just click that and here you'll be having this installer images thing. Just click that and if you just scroll down, you'll be having this 64-bit version, and the latest version of Kali Linux is 2023.3. And here we are having a download button. It's about 3.9 GB in size. Just click on download. So in the meantime, we can just go and download VirtualBox. So just go to Google and type download VirtualBox. You'll be getting the first link as virtualbox.org. Just click on downloads. And here you will be having for Windows host, Mac OS, Linux distributions. I'm using Windows, so I'll just click on Windows host and the download will be getting started. So it is about 106 MB in size. So just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just click on open. Just click on yes. And you'll be getting the Oracle VM VirtualBox setup. Just click on next. And these are the things that are going to get installed. So this is absolutely fine. And if you want to change the location, you can just click browse and change it. So after setting the location, just click on next and just click yes and just click yes. So this is fine and just click on install once you're done with all. So the VirtualBox installation is complete. So now that we have done installing VirtualBox and downloaded the ISO file, let's just, you know, integrate Kali Linux ISO file with VirtualBox. So for doing that, just open VirtualBox. You'll be having this Oracle VM, open it. And in this, you'll be having an option called as new, click that. And here we'll be specifying all the required details of our new virtual machine. So let me just name the name as Kali Linux. And this is the default location, I'm fine with this. If you want, you can just change it. And this is the place where we will be integrating our ISO file that we just downloaded. So if I just click this, here we'll be having this other. And here we'll be having the ISO file in the downloads. Select that and click on open. That's it, and its type is Linux. And here the version is going to be Debian 64. It is present at the top. Yeah, here it is. This is fine. And I think this is fine. We can just give it to the default thing. This is good. Next is going to be the hardware. This is going to be the RAM and the amount of processors that we are going to allocate to our virtual machine. So by default, it is 2 GB RAM and 1 CPU processor for that. We can just increase this to maybe 4 and you can just have it to 3 processors. This is fine. Next is going to be the hard disk. So by default it is assigned 20 GB. Let me just increase this to 30. Yeah, this will be fine. You can just, you know, assign it based upon your use case. And these are fine. I will just click on finish now. So here you can see I'm having this Kali Linux thing over here. And in case if you want to again change the RAM or any other settings that you had done earlier, you need to just select the Kali Linux virtual machine thing and to click on settings. You need to go to system and here you can see we'll be having the processor. So by this way, we will be able to like change the processor, the number of RAM that we're allocating over here. So once we're done with all the settings, we can just click on start for our Kali Linux to install in VirtualBox. Just click on the start. You need to select this and click on start. And we'll be doing the graphical installation, okay? So just click hit on enter key, okay? And this is the beginning of the installation process. You need to select the language over here. I will just leave the English as default. If you want to change the language, you can just, you know, click on that. I will just click English and I'll click on continue. And the location, you need to just select your location over here. I will go with my country's location and I'll just click on continue. After this, you need to select the keyboard type. American is fine. I'll just click on continue again. And you can leave the host name as default Kali, that's fine. You can just click on continue and you can just leave it blank, continue. And here you need to specify the full name of the user, so I'll just leave it as new user. You can give your name or something here, that's your choice. I'll just click on continue. Yeah, this is the username for your account, you can configure that. I will click continue again and here you need to enter the password. And once you have entered the password, just click on continue. and just go with the default one, use entire disk and click on continue. Yeah, this is the memory that we have allocated, that is the hard disk space earlier. Just click on continue. And all files, this is fine. Go with the default one, just click on continue. And finish partitioning, yeah, I'll just click on continue now. And yeah, you need to just select yes over here and click on continue. And you can just leave it to the default option here. Just click on continue. And it will ask you to install Grub Bootloader. Just click on yes and continue. And you need to select the hard disk, okay? This thing, you need to just click here and you need to click on continue. And after that, we'll be getting installation complete, which means that we have successfully installed Kali Linux. And now we need to just reboot. So for rebooting, we need to just click on continue. And now we will be getting a dialog box to enter our username and password. So you need to enter the username that you had mentioned earlier. So I'll just go with my username and password. And I'll just click on login. So here you can see I am getting the Kali Linux interface available over here. I'm inside the OS. And I think it is not present in full screen. Okay, it is in full screen. Yeah, so this is by default in full screen. If you want full screen mode, you can just click on view full screen mode. And if you click on switch, you'll be getting this view over here. And this is the folders and files available there. And if you want to like go away from the full screen view, you can just click on full screen mode again. So you'll be getting the small view or, you know, windowed view over here. So this is basically how you download and install Kali Linux and set it up for VirtualBox. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of programming videos and AI related videos. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.